If you've been watching this channel for a while, you've heard me recently talk about how I split some locks. I actually filmed this video a few months ago, but didn't get a chance to upload it. So in today's video, you're going to see how I went about unraveling my hair and relocking my hair. The reason why I did this is when I first started locking my hair, when I originally got the two strand twists in, some sections were larger than the others. And as you continue to watch, you're going to see what those sections look like. I thought I could let it go, but it bugged me enough to unravel it. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I unravel a lock. I've been meaning to do this for a really long time, and I'm going to talk as I do this. The items that I'm going to be using, I'm just going to dive right into this, is a comb, just a rat tail comb. And then I'm just gonna be using some water. This is water in a spray bottle. And I'm using some moisturizing lotion, hair cream that I have. I currently don't have conditioner on hand, so I'm hoping that this is going to work. So I'll dive right in. So I'm in the middle of a retwist. I actually am pretty much done, and I just have this front portion to take care of. As you can see, the front portion of the hair is much bigger. It's a much bigger part than the rest of them, and I'd like to fix that. So how I'm gonna fix that is by splitting the lock and restarting the lock journey. Now, ideally, you should be using conditioner when you do this, but I don't have conditioner right now. I also have another little comb that I'm gonna be using, a baby comb. That's hopefully gonna help with this process. So I'll get started and we'll see what the end result is going to be. So right now it's about 5:44 p.m. I'll let you know how long it takes me to unravel this one lock, and then we'll come back and then I'll let you know my thoughts about this whole process. I actually want to begin this video by giving a full disclosure that I had no idea what I was doing when I was doing this. I looked all over for how to unravel a lock and I wasn't successful in my search. So I honestly just made stuff up. So I knew conditioner tends to soften the hair, makes it easier to comb, and I thought that might be nice as I am combing the lock out. I used a rat tail comb because it's very little, it's very fine, and then the end, I thought it'd be nice to be able to take out the lock or detangle the lock. And then over here, you see me using my baby's comb because it also had the fine teeth on one side. You know, in all honesty, I was prepared to lose a lot of hair, and that's something, if you are going to consider doing this, be prepared to lose a lot of hair because your hair has been tangled for so long and it hasn't shed. So that's what you're going to see. You know, when people say that you cannot comb out your locks, you have to shave off your hair, I honestly feel like if you wanted to, you could. I actually have seen some videos of people who decided to do that, but their hair is extremely thin afterwards. So I guess you'd have to decide whether it's worth it or not. So it took some time as I was using my comb, and I realized that I was hitting like a dead end, basically. Nothing was happening. So I decided, and eventually you're gonna see, to cut that end piece, because that piece was the most locked compared to the rest of my hair. So as your hair grows, the piece that was closer to your scalp moves down and it ends up being towards the end of your lock, if that makes sense. So that's what was going on here. I tried combing, I tried adding conditioner, and I felt like I was getting no movement. So I kept at it until I finally decided to give up. Now, if you're paying attention to the parting, you can really tell that it's probably two or three times bigger than the rest of my locks. Now, this wasn't a big deal as my hair was locking because you couldn't tell. My locks were in two strand twists and everything looked uniform. But over time, as my locks have matured and as they continue to lock up, they have taken their own size, and I can definitely tell with the parting. And this would show when I would wear my hair down. I like to part my hair to the side sometimes, sometimes the middle, but I felt like it was very obvious that that part was significantly bigger. If your locks have changed over time as you've progressed in your lock journey, let me know. Are they smaller? Are they bigger? I know sometimes people's locks thin out after some time as they continue to get longer, but anyways, it's interesting
So over here, you'll just see me playing around between using the metal end of the comb, the comb, the teeth part of the comb, I don't know what they're called, until I figure out a solution. Again, completely making stuff up. So snipped off the end because I wasn't trying to struggle with it anymore, and this changed things. My hair, honestly, this felt like I was taking down box braids. You know that feeling when you're getting close to the end and it's almost out? That's the feeling I had as I was doing this. Use my ashy hand. It is what it is. So as I was getting closer, I got excited. What's really interesting was feeling my hair loose like this. It's been a long time since I've seen my hair this way. I even forgot what my hair pattern looked like. So this is what it is. And honestly, after seeing this section, I don't miss having loose natural hair because the amount of shedding I had, I understand this is because my hair was locked, but the amount of shedding I would have when I was a loose natural was just out of this world, because I have extremely thick hair. Not saying that thick hair needs to have shedding, but I don't like seeing hair all over. I don't like seeing hair in the shower. I don't like seeing it on counters. And that's unfortunately something that I had to deal with when I was a loose natural. So over here, I'm just combing out just to make sure the hair, combing out the hair to make sure that I get any loose strands out. And I was doing a little mini length check just to see how long the hair actually was. It's always interesting to think about how long your hair actually is. Like, is it the actual length that is when it's in locks, or is it longer? So I did that and then played around with it, just looking at the texture. And then in a little bit, now I wanted to decide how many times I wanted to split this lock. Did I want it two ways or three ways? And I ended up going with two ways because it seemed to match the parts of the other section. And you guys, this was such a great relief. When I got to this point where I split the lock, I was like, this is what I needed to do like yesterday, like a long time ago. So I'm really pleased with this decision. I'm happy.
So I'm all done unraveling my hair. It took me not long at all. Right now it's 5:56, so I want to say under 20 minutes to do. I did have to cut the lock in half just so it was easier. I noticed that towards the end of the lock was a little bit harder to take apart. I don't know if it's because it was a little bit thinner or because it's been locked for some time. I should mention that I've been locked for about 2 years now. Well, I should say 2 years now. So that's how much time it's taken for me to unravel my lock. And this is how long the hair is after cutting it. I would say I cut about an inch off. So this is what it is right now. And it doesn't feel thin. I did lose quite a bit of hair. If I'm to show you the amount of hair that I've combed off, is this is gross because it has like the conditioner in it, but this is what the hair looks like right now. I am going to just do some two strand twists, just restarting the lock journey, or I might interlock it. I'm not entirely sure how I'm gonna do this. Maybe I'll interlock it. Or maybe let's just do the two strand twists because that's how I started the rest of it. So I'm just gonna two strand twist it. And I might change this up to interlocking it if I notice that it's taking some time to lock. Just gonna two strand twist. So what's gonna happen is this is gonna be more bouncy than the rest of the locks in my hair. But for the most part, let's see. Okay, and these are my two new locks, two two new additions to the Locke family. I plan on just wearing my hair back like that, so it shouldn't be that big of a deal. But as you can see, the part looks so much better now that it's split in two versus it being one. I think it'll just help with the overall look of the hairstyle. Otherwise, hopefully this was helpful. I will see you in the next video. Thanks so much for watching.